Hello, and welcome to an introduction to RadioDNS. Radio as we know it is becoming more multi-platform. More than ever before, radio is reaching people in new and different ways. And if the experience of the UK is anything to go by, people are now expecting radio everywhere, where they want it, how they want it. So we already know that the future of radio is multi-platform. But broadcast radio is scalable, cheap, and portable. So it's the primary part of our multi-platform broadcast future. And with this comes a problem. Radio faces being left behind as more people experience visuals and more information on the same device that also picks up radio. To the left, this Samsung phone is playing an MP3. To the right, we're hearing the same song on the radio. It's all a bit 87.5. So, we need more functionality. We need bookmarking, visuals, ways to contact broadcasters, and more. So, looking at radio receivers these days, many of them now have the internet built in. From mobile phones with FM chips inside them, to internet radio sets, FM-equipped laptops and music players, they all have access to radio and the internet in one box. So if we want rich radio, we can use web services over the internet, use broadcast radio for portability and scalability, and the internet for visuals, data, and feedback. But there's a problem. When your radio tunes into a radio station, it has no idea where to find the online web services. So it can't connect. Broadcast radio works really well. And the internet is great for additional information, personalization, and feedback. But how can we link the two? How can we tell a connected radio where to find a radio station's web services? There is an obvious answer, and that obvious answer is to add this information into a radio station's broadcasts in additional metadata. But changing the broadcast chain is expensive, it requires additional standard setting, and it's a lot of hard work. So the good news is, we're already broadcasting the metadata that can be used. In FM RDS, or DAB, or HD radio, or more, we're already broadcasting unique identifiers that can be used to help link broadcasting with the internet. So in London, an FM radio might see A0C201 when it's listening to BBC Radio 1 on FM, or it might see this bunch of numbers for capital on DAB. Those numbers already exist. And what RadioDNS does is create a CNAME that points your radio to the broadcaster, enabling your radio to find out from the broadcaster what services the broadcaster supports over IP. Now, these services might be visualizing radio, adding personalized images perhaps, or an EPG or more information about radio stations, or feedback from advertising or things we've not yet thought about. But these technologies are already in use in products like the Pure Sensia connected radio, and there are more products being built as we speak that use RadioDNS technology. The documentation is open, so you can work on it right now, and it's been worked on by over 100 broadcasters worldwide. So if you'd like more information, please visit the RadioDNS website. It's at radiodns.org.